Hello learners, welcome back to the course on AI in Human Resource Management. In this particular lecture, we'll delve into the benefits of synergizing AI and HRM. We have discussed AI and HRM with quite detailed perspective, specifying different use cases, best practices, etc. Now we'll look into the benefits of synergizing AI and HRM. I'm Dr. Abraham Sir Issac. I'm an assistant professor at the School of Business, Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. Now, when you want to understand the benefits of synergizing AI in HRM, you have to first start with the evolution of AI. When you look into the evolution of AI in HRM, we see that it has a certain history. Late 1990s to early 2000, go back to, let's say, 100 years or something, which is not practically possible. But late 1990s to early 2000, this is where the initial seeds of AI were seen. With the rise of internet and online job onboards, AI began playing a vital role in HRM. So basic AI algorithms were used to match the job seekers with relevant job openings, etc. Though it was not specifically termed AI, but the thing is, it was there almost in the background. When you look into the mid-2000s, as AI technology advanced, the AR professionals adopted more advanced tools like applicant tracking systems or resume parsers to streamline recruitment management and improve the candidate screening efficiency. Then we further delve into the latest part, late 2000s to early 2010s. We see that the growth of social media and professional networking sites like, let's say, LinkedIn enabled the use of AI for talent acquisition, AI-driven analytics. Altogether, helped HR professionals identify and target potential candidates based on their online presence and activities. Mid-2010s to present, this is what we are interested in mainly. Recent advancements in AI and machine learning have had, the development of various HR applications, including chatbots for candidate engagement, NLP for analyzing the employee feedback, and predictive analytics for workforce planning and, of course, performance management. Now, when you look into HR innovation management altogether, it utilizes the traditional methods like, let's say, brown paper, flip charts, sticky notes, etc. So this is what has been time and again a time-tested perspective of the innovation management. Extent of digital expansion, let's look into this particular model where you'll see that analog tools based innovation management was at the bottom. Manual innovation was more keen or more streamlined. Then came the digital tool based innovation management. So you look into the expansion, it moves further to automated business model reconfiguration, etc. But when we talk about the base, the analog tool based innovation management, you see that generally it is the particular traditional method where you will see brown paper, flip charts, sticky notes, etc. So this level is low in terms of digital capability and relies on manual processes. Whereas you look into, let's say, the next level, digital-based, tool-based innovation management, we are looking into that in detail. When you look into, let's say, digital tool-based innovation specifically, moderate digital expansion is what you can see. It involves digital environments for collaboration, for rapid prototyping, and even for idea management. So this level certainly introduces some digital tools to enhance innovation, but still requires manual input. Then we have the automated business model reconfiguration, where there is high digital expansion moving towards automation. So AI enables automatic pricing, costing, and business partner mediation. So what we understand here is that innovation management benefits from AI-driven automation of core business functions. We have, again, finally automated business model development. So all these particular AI algorithms match problems with typical solutions. So AI algorithms at this stage, innovation management is fully automated, requiring minimal manual intervention. So what we generally see with respect to the whole aspect is that The x-axis measures the shift from manual to automated innovation management. So what we see here is this shift, whereas what we tend to capture with y-axis is the increasing extent of digital expansion altogether. So this is what we can ascertain by moving from not digital tools at the bottom to full automation at the top. Now, when we look into AI applications in HRM, let's look into this quickly. We have seen it. We have discussed this many a time. So very quickly, we'll move through it. Since we are looking into the sync between AI and HRM, we have to again track down to these simple aspects. But again, since we have discussed, we move fast. Recruitment, AI-driven recruitment tools such as applicant tracking system simplify the hiring process by automating tasks like candidate screening, interview coordination, background checks, etc. So the machine learning algorithms in AI recruitment platforms, they analyze large data sets to identify patterns that predict candidate success, enabling organizations to make more informed hiring decisions. When you look into retention, what we have seen across the previous modules is that AI helps improve employee retention by using predictive analytics, machine learning, personalized career development, etc. So what we understand with respect to this is that AI tools, they support a certain niche area of personalized career development and learning opportunities, promoting the employee growth and satisfaction. When you look into employee engagement, we have the AI-powered HR tools like chatbots, sentiment analysis, software enhancing employee engagement by improving communication, by offering a real-time feedback and highlighting areas that need attention. So AI typically analyzes engagement data to uncover trends and patterns, helping HR design strategies that boost employee satisfaction and productivity. Now, when you look into the data-driven decision-making in HRM, again, which we have touched upon in the previous module, we can categorize the understanding based on these parameters. One is that it optimizes the HR process. AI-driven analytics assist HR teams in identifying inefficiencies and workflow bottlenecks, allowing them to make data-driven decisions to improve overall process efficiency. The second would be to improve the workforce planning. When you look into the predictive analytics, AI-powered predictive analytics, it enables organizations to forecast future work requirements, pinpoint the skill gaps, if any, and create targeted strategies for talent acquisition and certain extent the development of that. When you look into the third aspect, it is more about tracking and assessing the performance. So AI-based HRM tools allow organizations to monitor employee performance more accurately and objectively, so aiding in informed decisions about performance management and compensation. When you look into the benefits of synergizing AI in HRM, we can see that there is increased efficiency. AI-based HR tools can handle repetitive and time-consuming tasks, allowing HR professionals to focus on what is strategic, what is a higher value activity. We have improved decision-making, and this is critical because AI-powered analytics offer deeper workforce insights, helping HR teams make more informed decisions that align with the company goals. We have enhanced talent acquisition and management. AI-driven tools improve recruitment by identifying and attracting top candidates, creating personalized career development plans, boosting employee engagement, retention, etc. We also have increased adaptability. AI-powered HR tools enable organizations to respond quickly to changing market conditions, workforce needs and technological advancements, keeping them competitive and prepared for the future. Now, when you look into the strategies for successful implementation of AI in HRM, we have undoubtedly the training and education. HR professionals should undergo training and education programs that cover fundamental AI concepts like machine learning, data analytics, etc. We have the collaboration with IT departments and external partners, where you see that organizations should encourage HR professionals to collaborate with IT department and such cross-functional departments and establishments. Then we have creating an AI-centric HR culture, which is all about organizations that cultivate an AI-friendly culture within HR, one that embraces data-driven decision-making and technology-related innovation. We can also look into strategies such as promoting what we have understood as a more of a leadership commitment aspect. We can also see strategies like promoting a data-driven culture, like leadership commitment, where top management must emphasize the importance of data-driven decision-making and AI-driven HRM practices. You know, leaders should clearly communicate expectations, provide necessary resources that are that should be provided, and actively support. Leaders should clearly communicate expectations, provide necessary resources, and actively support the adoption of these practices to motivate HR professionals and employees to embrace AI in HRM. We should have also a look into data accessibility and literacy. Organizations must ensure that HR professionals and employees have easy access to relevant data and are trained in terms of data literacy. So systems and processes should be implemented typically to allow easy data sharing and access, enabling better decision making and collaboration with HR teams. We also need to have employee involvement, involving employees in developing and implementing the AI-driven HRM practices. So it promotes knowledge sharing, it promotes collaboration, it will reinforce the data-driven culture which we were talking about previously. We also have to ensure ethical AI deployment in HR. So what happens is that the transparency and explainability sometimes gets a hit. So we have to ensure that AI algorithms and decision-making processes are transparent, they are explainable. Transparent AI systems allow organizations to typically detect and correct biases or inaccuracies and address those issues and ensure that fairness and accuracy is there in all the decision-making process. We also can look into it from the data privacy and security angle. Now, what we understand here is that measures like encryption, data anonymization, or restricting access to authorized personals, these things are vital. These things are essential. So ensuring data privacy and security helps build trust in AI systems and prevents risk related to data breaches or misuse. We also have to look into addressing bias and discrimination. Particularly, AI systems may unintentionally reinforce biases or discrimination if not, you know, carefully designed and monitored. So organizations should assess the quality and diversity of the data used to train AI models. They should regularly audit AI system for fairness and include diverse stakeholders in AI design and evaluation process. That said, there are certain challenges of AI-driven systems, ethical considerations. We will not go deeper because we have already seen with respect to bias and discrimination. We have also seen with respect to data privacy, you know, compliance with data privacy regulations such as GDPR or APEC privacy framework, the Asia-Pacific privacy framework is vital. So these laws set guidelines for data collection, processing, and storage. Organizations must implement typically strong data protection measures such as data anonymization, encryption, secure storage, etc. There are also certain cultural differences or culture and legal implications, including culture difference and adaptation and legal compliance. So when you look into things from a culture and legal angle, you'll see that AI-driven HRM systems may be perceived and accepted differently across various culture, various contexts. Be it in Asia, be it in US, be it in any other Western culture, potentially impacting their effectiveness. To ensure success, organizations need to adapt their AI systems by considering local cultural norms and preferences. So this may involve customizing communication strategies, user interfaces, and system features. So what we understand with respect to legal compliance is a reinforcement of the cultural aspirations. When you look into the legal compliance, you know, AI-driven HRM raises legal concerns, particularly in areas like data protection or labor laws or something like discrimination. So when you are looking into Asian organizations particularly, they must navigate a complex and inconsistent legal environment as AI and data regulations differ across jurisdiction. And this is the challenge. To minimize the legal risk, companies need to stay updated on regulatory changes and ensure compliance with relevant laws. So collaborating with legal experts is crucial to develop policies on data collection, algorithmic decision-making, and employee rights. When you're looking into ensuring human-AI collaboration, with respect to what we have as of now, we have to. There is no other alternative other than building trust. So we need to offer training and education programs that can help employees comprehend the benefits and limitations of AI in HRM, boosting their confidence in working with these technologies. Also, we can balance automation and human expertise to a large extent. Let's say AI should be seen as a tool that complements human skills rather than replacing them. So encouraging collaboration between HR professionals and AI systems allows organizations to maximize the strengths of both human expertise and AI technology in HRM. So this is what I wanted to quickly make you aware about the possibilities, the benefits that AI brings in the domain of HRM. I think that there are some key takeaways with respect to the benefits and with respect to the challenges, which also needs to be considered meticulously while implementing, let's say, AI in HRM domain in your organization. If you are a practitioner or learning AI in HRM, specifically if you are a student. So we'll come with more details in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.